Thursday morning on our way to the weekend, and a very nice weekend for the Mid-South as we go throughout the next couple of days. Drier, cooler air dropping out of Canada, and that's going to make things very nice for the Mid-South area. Hope you've had a great week so far. I'm meteorologist Austin Onick. This is the Weather from Oz podcast, talking about weather on Thursday morning, the 17th of September. And again, on the midway through the month, things again pretty quiet for the time being. We could get some very roasty temperatures at this time of the year, not happening at this point. And we're pretty clear of anything involving storms either. Nothing showing up on radar this morning. A few very light sprinkles, possibly maybe a few smoke plumes back to the west of Little Rock this morning from some wildfires out there, but not seeing anything, excuse me, in the way of any problems where it comes to anything in the way of rain or thunderstorms or severe weather or anything like that. Pretty quiet as well. When it comes to air quality, we're looking at some pretty nice conditions across much of the area for this morning once again, as we see the possibility of some very good air quality for most of the Mid-South. Again, for right now, for the Memphis metro area, we are showing again green or good air quality, and the forecast for today and tomorrow looks to be staying the same, which is a far cry from what's going on out west. The fires, anything on the west coast is showing some very poor air quality. Washington State, Northern California, and also back into Oregon. Another large storm system sweeping on through would help with this, like the snow that helped to dampen some of the fires in and around parts of Colorado and the Colorado Front Range area. So for right now, looking at pretty poor air quality, but things pretty nice here in the area. But the smoke, you're going to continue to see gray skies as that smoke from out west drifts overhead in the next few days. What can we say about the tropics? Active as though it has never been like this in modern history. About seven different systems out there under observation. What's left of Sally at this time? Now a tropical depression and moving its way over the southeastern United States. Several inches of rainfall will be possible from this storm as it makes its way over toward the Carolinas. After the Carolinas, as it moves offshore, might see another system out of this again. Will it be named the same thing? Well, if it gets that strong, we'll have to wait and see. But it's left a lot of its energy behind as it goes over parts of the southeast U.S. New storm system in the Bay of Campeche. Looks like it's going to be heading up the eastern Mexican coastline and then curving back toward Texas. It does not appear to be a threat for right now. As you can see, a couple of the spaghetti models, the lines, the different model runs taking the storm a little farther off to the east, even close to the mouth of the Mississippi and the Mississippi Delta. But again, that's going to be a system we'll have to watch, but it is not developed into anything right now. Hurricane Hunter Plane will be investigating this thing coming up later on this afternoon, and we'll see how strong and structured this thing is. Teddy, hurricane in the Atlantic. Expected to be a major hurricane by tomorrow morning. That's a Category 3 and above. And as we go into the next several days, it looks like Bermuda is going to get whacked twice in as many weeks from this system. Heading into next week, curving upwards into the North Atlantic could be a problem for the Canadian Maritimes. So that could be something for the East Coast to keep an eye on, but not a threat for the East Coast, at least as of right now. We have some very nice weather with high pressure perfectly positioned over parts of Hudson Bay and southern Canada to escort down a lot of cool, dry air. Now, we're not going to see any frost or anything, although we are getting closer to that time of the year. We will see some much nicer conditions over the next several days as that front begins to amble on through, getting into tonight, tomorrow, and into Friday. So for right now, the good news, the upshot for us, is that we have little, if anything, to detect in the way of severe or active weather coming our way. And also, via the Weather Underground, the 10-day forecast for the Memphis metro area, we should be looking at, again, some very good conditions. Temperatures over the next several days, looking at numbers back into the mid-80s today. Again, that's a little bit below normal. As we go into around Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, absolutely gorgeous. Upper 70s to lower 80s for highs, lower to mid-50s for low temperatures. That's not too bad. Can be fairly typical at this time of the year. But into the next few days, as you see, we have plenty of sunshine And our next best chance of anything involving rainfall looks like it's at least a week to 10 days away. So we are going to be seeing a lot of dry conditions out there. Good for getting out in the yard, taking a walk, shaking off that cabin fever, doing your best to get, again, the possibility of some fresh air will always do you good. But again, remember to wear that mask, and we'll talk more about that coming up in just a little bit. Now is the time with nothing going on to learn about severe weather, and the National Weather Service can help you do that. They teach skywarn spotter training courses, and the next round is going to be coming up in the very near future. Starting in a couple of weeks, these will be online and will be divided up by counties. So if you would like to take the course, all you have to do is register, sign up. It's totally free, paid for by your tax dollars and my tax dollars. And one of the best things that the government does to make certain the citizenry stays safe and aware and is able to help each other by spotting for severe weather. It's a great opportunity for kids. I've seen kids as young as 8 or 9 years old sign up to be skywarn spotters. You learn what to look for. You learn what to call back or text, or if you're an amateur radio operator, what to call in on the severe weather nets, as they're called. And you find out more about this by, again, signing up. Now, again, because of the pandemic, everything is going to be online, and that's a little bit more convenient out there. And it's going to be, again, done by county. So if you're in Hardeman County, you're up on October the 1st. Decatur County, Tennessee, Monday, October the 5th. DeSoto County, Mississippi, Tuesday, October 20th. There is no Shelby County on here at this point. But again, it's depending on how many people sign up, you should be able to sign up for a particular course on here. So again, please note which county is listed. And if you have any questions, again, the information is down at the bottom of the page. You can contact the National Weather Service at that email address to find out more about what's going on. And of course, great folks at the National Weather Service, very instructive, able to give you, again, a good idea as to what to do when it comes to severe weather purposes. And this is your opportunity to help, so please consider doing so, just to be, again, a good neighbor and to make certain you are weather aware so you can get ready for what's coming on through. Haven't broken out the over-the-fence segment yet, neighbors talking to neighbors across the fence and just putting out there the information that might come in handy at some point in time. And this is something that has been a little bit more worrisome over the last several days and weeks, especially as sporting seasons have commenced and as the local health agency, Shelby County Health Department, has decreed the varying natures of lengths of people sitting, especially for sporting events, that when you're talking, again, wearing the mask, you are able to slow down the vapor coming out of your mouth that may be infected with the coronavirus. But when you're shouting and you're up and going at the game and you're able to, again, shout and project that stuff farther, that's why the Shelby County Health Department said you need to stay about 12 feet away from other participants, and that's why there were so few people in the Liberty Bowl this last time around. Well, a lot of grousing about that going on out there, and that is something that has been a little bit interesting, that a lot of people who have no scientific training whatsoever are able to tell the doctors, the epidemiologists, the virologists, the specialists with decades of experience, and apparently have, again, not much more than a high school education when it comes to planning and emergency management for the community, are able to say that it's a tragedy that we are doing something like this to help out, again, in the community. That is something that is very, again, worrisome. And again, the social distancing is there for a reason, to slow down the virus. If we all were to social distance, make less trips out into the community as per necessary, and also wear the masks, we might have been back to normal at this point. But unfortunately, a lot of people are not doing that, and they're considering this whole thing a hoax, which is too bad, and also, again, very tragic in and of its own self. The reason that these social distancing ideas have been put into place has been to slow the virus down. And again, this is something that is very important, that putting the mask on, that's good. Putting the mask on, social distancing, washing your hands, all that type stuff is going to help slow things down. Not wearing the masks and doing a lot of dangerous stuff like touching surfaces and then touching your face, again, that could spread stuff to other locations and make other people sick. So you really need to make an effort to social distance as well as wearing the masks and to promote science. The people who are in charge of the Shelby County Health Department have reasons for what they are doing, and they will explain that on their biweekly press conferences. And again, if you have questions, you can always call the department and ask to speak to somebody. Ask to speak to your doctor. Ask to speak to a nurse. Call your healthcare hotline and ask them. Don't just sit there and grouse about the fact that you want the Liberty Bowl full, because that is what is normal. So making certain that as long as we have a packed Liberty Bowl, everything's just fine. It is not just fine. It is something that we need to make certain that we take care of, to take care of each other, to spread people out so we don't infect more people. Sturgis bike rally in South Dakota. 1 out of 5 cases in the United States are now linked to that Sturgis rally. It is happening. This is a serious situation. And unfortunately, very soon, about 200,000 people will have paid for it with their lives. So if you think you know more by doing sports commentary on the radio or by flipping burgers, you state that you know more than the doctors and the virologists and the epidemiologists out there, that's a pretty brave statement. I don't. I don't know more than them, and I trust their judgment because this is what they do for a living. So, again, something to think about out there, that if you don't have the noust and the skills to determine what will help the community, maybe you should be quiet and listen to the people who actually do know what's going on, because otherwise that makes you look like a pretty big jerk. So just stating that. Anyway, that's off my soapbox for now. Thank you for letting me get that off my chest. More information from my big three websites, but again, also on various other social medias out there. We'll continue to, again, keep an eye on what's going on with the tropics, which, again, could change over the next several days. So definitely want to keep an eye on that. Meteorologist Austin Onick at gmail.com. If you got a question, send it to me directly. And of course, we'll be doing more weather as much as we possibly can here from House Onick. Thanks for joining us this morning. I'm meteorologist Austin Onick. You've been watching Weather from Oz. Stay tuned for much more here on my social media channels.